things that we need me to believe that my God is true. Does that make sense?
That's a personal experience, which is subjective.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
For example, so, give us an example of experience.
Come on, you can tell us.
So my point, the only reason I said that is because you said that incorrectly, so that I should pray for the truth, right?
No, but I'm not talking about you. So what I'm telling you, now we give you a logical argument, yeah, which is clearly has, in our respect, clearly
you
has
well,
shaken. He's a Christian, he's a Christian. So it's basically, I'm behind you, say it to you. Yeah. Clearly, what we have established, that go and guess what you believe. Understand? So now what I'm saying, think about it deeply, of course, and think. Okay, Islam, the way they describe God, is in a perfect manner. We don't believe God became baby, someone take care of him, then someone had to die, then we don't believe all of that. We believe God created the universe based upon his wisdom and mercy and justice. He chose people amongst us as a prophets and messengers, and he gave them miracles and prophecies to show the people what is our purpose of life. And all of them are prophets of God. We don't believe Prophet Muhammad is God, none of that. Understand? We believe one God is a perfect God. So what I'm saying, we look to the teaching of Islam, and also should ask yourself, even there is a huge war against Islam. You know, the war that is against Islam, if it was against any religion, that religion would be buried a long time ago. But the war that is against Islam is unbelievable. Islam is terrorist, Islam press women, but the majority of people that accept Islam in Britain are women.
So I'm saying,
Allah mentioned the Quran, that to Prophet Muhammad, Allah mentioned that the Islamic haters, they will dislike Islam to spread, but Allah will cause it to spread. So we have many logical arguments and tangible proof, which is universal, to come to realize that Islam is the truth.
And the same thing is with Christianity, exactly the same thing.
No, it's not.
Literally, if you, 300 Christianity, and you can search it up, is one of the most persecuted religions. Over 300 million Christians are persecuted in some way around the
can
world.
Can you name me one Christian country that's been invaded now?
Pardon? No, Christians. I didn't say Christian country, I said Christians.
Can you name me a Christian country that's been invaded because of Christianity?
At the moment, yeah. I will not name you a Christian country. What I'm saying...
How many Muslim countries have been invaded and destroyed?
No. What I'm saying is Christian... I didn't say...
I understand that.
Christian country. And this is when you're... I've acknowledged without evidence, without necessary evidence,
that's the thing that...
In fact, never mind. I've acknowledged what you've said, right?
Okay.
Without looking in the Quran with what you've said, and I've acknowledged it, whether I believe it or not, is something I've acknowledged it.
Yeah, no, what I'm saying...
Christianity, and someone can search it up now, is extremely persecuted.
For example, give me one country.
No. Okay, look.
In what country the Christians been persecuted with Christianity?
Let me tell you something.
Yeah, yeah.
In fact, Christians in the Middle East persecuted. That's
not
obvious.
True. That's not true.
Okay.
That's not
okay,
true. You know why? I'll tell you why. There's a church.
No, sorry. So you're saying that's not true. I'm saying that's true. That's true.
What is it?
If you just look around,
There's nothing.
Okay. So
do you
understand that you're asking me for proof, but the proof. In fact, no, we'll just leave it to the people here.
Okay, no,
later,
but what I'm
later
saying,
you can research.
No, the
no,
what
no,
I'm
sorry,
saying,
sorry.
Fine, listen. I'm not
so
saying
later,
there's no
later
Christian.
You can research.
I'm not saying there's no Christian in the Muslim countries being harmed by Muslims. I'm not saying no, but I'm saying to say Arabic bushes is widespread among in the Middle East. That is not true at all. Because why? Before America invaded Iraq, even Shia and Sunni, there was no problem at all. But when America invaded Iraq, and America came to Iraq, somehow Shia and Sunni start killing each other. Somehow the Christians start getting tortured and all of that. Understand? Because in Islam, clearly, we have to take care of people of the book.
Sorry, did you say somehow Christians become tortured?
Yeah, because yeah.
So
because,
you admit that Christians did become.
But
tortured.
Why? Why? How come before America invaded Iraq? We never heard of these problems.
Sorry, by the way, I don't know this. Like,
that's what happened.
I do not know this.
Sunnis and Shia, yeah. They never used to fight each other the way it's happening now.
Yeah,
America, the heroes, who saved the world, they made it worse.
And then Christians and Muslims became persecuted.
Yeah, but no. Do you know why? By who? By the extremists.
But you did say that they. And my point was My point was that Christians are being persecuted.
No, no, not being the way like Muslims. Not like Muslims.
That's your opinion.
Bro.
What you've said.
Our country has been invaded because we are Muslims.
Okay. But I'm not saying that Christians are being murdered or persecuted in a country, in a Christian country. What I'm saying is that Christians around the world, in their own sense, and some statistics are being persecuted within themselves. Does that make sense?
Within themselves, what do you mean?
Like within, there's no country that I know, and that I can say, I'm not saying that it doesn't exist, that has, they've gone to, they persecuted because they're Christians.
I don't know the country. Yeah, yeah.
Does that make sense?
Okay.
But what I'm saying, like,
do you know why he brought that point though in the first place? Because he's saying, why is Islam being attacked so much by people? No, but once again, why are people accepting Islam? Because Islam goes in line with the natural inclination and sound reasoning. Your belief in Christianity is based on your experience. If you go to most people, you can't go and say, let me speak. No one goes and becomes a Christian because his friend said, I saw Jesus in my dream, therefore Christianity must be right. Why? Because the person's going to look at Christians and say,
so if we're taking your time, man.
Don't worry.
All the prophets and messengers call to one God who is the most perfect, who is the creator of everything. Christians are saying that no, that God manifested as a man, he walked down the street and that's God. That makes sense. It doesn't make sense.
Okay,
the reason why middle-aged women with university degrees, that's the highest demographic of people accepting Islam, is because Islam makes sense. It's not something
even a prophecy Allah mentioned in the Quran. It's a prophecy.
That's okay, no.
You lot are going on a tangent.
The reason what I said when I talked about my personal experience, that was in relation to what he said. I did not say I was Christian because of personal experience. I said that personal experience. Let me explain it. He said, and you can
maybe
look back
forgot,
in the video.
Forgot.
No, he. You said to me, I should pray. To find the truth.
No, well, no, because of that only because we we proved to you that what you believe in a reality doesn't make any sense. So you agreed that, you know what, let me go back, and I said, you know what, pray to God as well. Not just go pray to God without proving to you what you believe is incorrect. So part of the reason I told you go pray to God, because we already showed you with a logical argument that, and a textual argument, that Jesus cannot be God.
Sorry, you didn't, what you did, and because as I said, I'm relatively ignorant in Christianity and the arguments for Christianity. So if you posted me a Muslim argument against Christianity, I'm almost defenseless against it. But if you pose that to a, if you pose the same argument you posed to me against a Christian scholar, I guarantee you they'll have a much better response. So when you said that you proved to me that it was illogical, you only told me your side of the argument. If I went and looked at the Christian argument, which I'm yet to do,
you can't, because the truth is one. If we establish Jonathan, if we establish what we said is the truth, therefore nothing can go against it.
We didn't establish that it was the truth. We established that it makes sense.
No, it's the truth. It's the truth that God is perfect eternally. Mean no way he will be imperfect at any time. That's the truth.
What I'm saying is that I need to look more into the Bible and what the Bible said about Jesus, and then relate that to what you said. Because if I look back and it says something different about Jesus, or says something that explains why he was able to turn into Jesus, then that disproves what you said. Does that make sense?
No, it doesn't disprove the reality. For example, if they're going to tell you Jesus, he didn't know the hour because he became human, that does not negate the reality that God is perfect all the time and eternally, and he should not go and guess his perfection at any time.
So you explain that
Jesus became human, that will not help it.
If you go on your phone and you type on most persecuted religion, everything is saying Christian persecution at near genocide levels. Christians are the most persecuted religion.
Do you know how Google works?
Are Christians the most... This is incognito.
Do you know Google?
Wait.
Do you know how Google works?
No.
Google doesn't give you the correct answer. It gives you the most famous answer. The most popular answer.
So
Google doesn't give you the
question. But this is the fact. This is the statistic. Yeah. This is the statistic. You can't have different statistics.
Wait. Look.
I mean, at this point...
Look. In India, where the country called Haro...
Rohingya.
They're being killed because they are clearly Muslims.
Yep.
Bush attacked Iraq because they are a Muslim.
Kashmir.
Okay. They don't play around
Palestine.
That. There's many Muslims. You have no problem for a woman or a man to walk naked But you have a problem because a Muslim woman wants to cover herself.
By the way, that's not me.
No, you're not.
He's not about me. I've said nothing against Muslim women.
No, sorry. I'm talking about what's happening in the West. And I said it, you know, I have to speak the truth. The best country in the West for the Muslims are Britain. The way Britain had the Muslims to practice their religion, without any doubt, because Allah said, "Wa ma jazaa'ul ihsani illa ihsan." There's nothing, that the reward of goodness except goodness. Here, they have the Muslims, even you see Muslim working offices with niqab and everything. But like Belgium, Holland, this country, France is the biggest hypocrite. France, they say, what they call it, democracy, la liberté, yes? And they say, we force our women to wear hijab, correct? That's what they say. Guess what? Okay, look to the hypocrisy. But you are forcing our women to take off hijab and they choose to wear it. So it's okay for you to force them to take it off for the sake of argument, but it's not okay for us to say. So Muslims worldwide, they've been prosecuted, so they've been tortured, they've been killed because of their religion.
Okay, so what you told me is that in the West, there are some countries that are persecuting Muslims.
Oppressing Muslim women, right. And
what I'm saying that...
Not just in the West, in India, Africa...
I'm saying that in the West, we have countries as well that are discriminating against Christians. And if we go to the...
Which country?
There are statistics that are saying that Christians are the most...
It's not true, man. The reality is...
You're arguing against statistics because you're...
Bro, who wrote the statistics? Who wrote it?
Okay.
I don't know him.
What do you mean? I can't, literally...
That's what I'm saying. You just went to Google, you ask. There's not the way how you do research. Jonathan, there's not the way you do research about issues like that. You don't go to Google.
Google.
No, not like that, Jonathan.
Fine.
But I would ask, not leave all of this side. Well, I was going to ask you something here. Reflect upon what we said to you.
Okay, it says an independent review for no
To generalize, to summarize everything, think about it. And as I mentioned, that remember how Islam described God, there's no contradiction. How Christianity described God, contradiction.
I don't know what
happened.
I have to go pray.
Wait, one more thing.
Okay, yeah.
If you say yes or no, and then yes or no, and then we can go. I'm not arguing with you, just yes or no, and then we can go. You know, is one of Allah's names the deceiver?
Allah in the Quran, he says, In the Quran, Allah said,
don't make it come from you. Drop it. You ain't getting nowhere with him. Drop it.
You want to hear the answer?
You're not getting nowhere with him.
So you ask me the question about the Siva.
Please, don't make him twist your head.
I'm saying we'll ask you, it doesn't have to be scholar, you don't have to be scholar to know it.
Because, as I said, I might not know an argument.
No problem, you go learn, I don't mind.
I don't have time to talk about Islam.
God is perfect all the time. God is perfect all the time. He was not talking to me. We have to go pray.
I didn't want to be grown. No, I've been watching you. I decided to keep quiet because I didn't want to interrupt.
You know what?
So I've been here for like 20 minutes. I didn't say
what you're doing.
I didn't
say
a word.
Preaching, I'm not talking about preaching, but when I was talking to him, you were silent. I respect that.
It's good.
Because I don't want one guy to take my video and say, Shamsi expects preaching Christianity. You know, some people, they look. In the Quran, Allah said, they try to deceivers.
I look a boy.
It's a little boy. Are you a baby?
No, it's okay.
How old are you, sir?
You know, there's an age for you to be on camera legally. How old are you?
Alhamdulillah, today we had a Shahada.
Wow, you're 16.
Yeah, 61. No, you're not.
Okay, no.
We have to check these things.
So let's say these things,
bro.
Wait.
Wait, guys, silence. I need to clean something up.
16-year-old.
Guys.
Really? He wouldn't answer my question.
Let him speak.
I'm not.
Look, Christians, they have no respect for Christians.
No, let him talk.
They have no respect for Christians.
Let him talk. Let's see what Shamsi is taking on.
No. I was standing here, and then he
giant killer.
A question. He asked you a question. No, he asked me a question. And
okay, what was the question?
Yeah.
I can't remember the question.
No, he was talking about him. There was him, and there was agnostic guy. You were talking about what is justice, and I jumped in when you speaking to the brother, and I said justice to give everyone what he deserves. Then we start talking. I said, "What are you, a Christian?" Then the agnostics start talking about God, and I said,
"Oh yeah, you
remember
about the Father."
Yeah, we talk about our Father. So help him out. Is God perfect eternally?
Yes.
No, Christian, silence.
Victory! Victory!
Don't start shouting! Don't start shouting!
Don't start shouting!
Let's go! Stop!
Dogs of fire, keep barking!
Should be ashamed of yourself!
Run!
Christian sister accepted Islam every week.
Amazing. You must be crying inside.
Do you want to see the messages we get from
Muslims?
Why isn't there any channel on Shamsi on Christian channel? Like, oh, yeah. Go, go, go. Hey, Shamsi! Hey, bro, Shamsi's ready. No, he's gonna pray. Is he praying again? Oh, you pray all the time, bro.
Unlike you, man. You said you love Jesus.
Not yet.